And if the first day is any indication, it's going to be a very busy year out there in Falcon Heights. Joe McCoy shows us what the fair is doing to keep you safe, especially as that heat really moves in for the weekend.
Tweezers. There is nail clippers.
Good luck finding anyone more prepared at the state fair than Paisley Filipowski.
I got this. You can buy it at the state fair. It spritzes you and it's a fan.
She competes every year with her grandfather to see who can have the better fair survival kit.
So I have like gum in here.
This includes a toothbrush, toilet paper, ibuprofen, band-aids, a portable hairbrush, and more. It's almost like she's ready to move in.
We have a bunch of sunscreen. He has a neck fan he puts around his neck.
And we just got this today.
With field-like temperatures expected in the mid-90s on Sunday and Monday,
sure.
EMS Medical Director for Regents Hospital, Dr. Aaron Burnett, is urging fairgoers to stay hydrated.
You walk so much, you eat so many salty foods here, which is good for the soul, but not always necessarily good for the body.
The official State Fair app will show you where all your goodies are located, but it also will tell you some important information, like where the 23 water refill stations are located.
The biggest thing we see is dehydration at the fair and heat exhaustion. So we really encourage people to use sunscreen, take advantage of that shade, take advantage of those air-conditioned buildings, and just remember, the fair is not a sprint, it's a marathon.
If you like the heat, then this is your weekend to come. But if you don't, meteorologists are predicting temperatures in the low 70s for next weekend. At the State Fair, Joe McCoy, Care 11 News.